Okay, so far we have done with some of the basics of CAD, some of the basics of mechanical engineering, and we have learned how to create 2D drawings in CATIA, and we have learned how to create 3D model. Okay,
हाँ सर
so next in this session so I'm going to explain some of the basics of finite element analysis. Okay, so by today or tomorrow I will assign you some of the projects. Okay, and I will tell you how the project would be and what are all the things you need to do. Okay, so basically what you need to do is, so suppose if I have given you the design and analysis of connecting rod or any component, so initially you have to do some of the introduction part. Okay, so you need to do some of the introduction part, so I will tell you how to do that. So after that you need to do some literature survey. You need to download the literature journal paper and you need to study it, and you need to review it. So minimum 15 papers you need to download. So individually I will assign you the projects. Okay, so
yes, sir.
And I will explain you how to make the report also. So before explaining the end project, so let me explain some of the basics of finite element analysis. Okay, so I will share the presentation. So all of you are getting this presentation?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I think I have explained you the new product development process, NPD process, right? So this is the industrial design cycle, same as new product development. So first what we'll do, we'll go for CAD, that is design concept, then design the modeling. So whatever the component we are going to create, that we are going to generate the 3D modeling. Okay, same thing you need to do in this internship program. So once you design the model, next you need to perform analysis. Okay, so once you perform analysis, you need to do optimization. What do you mean by optimization? Can you please explain? Anyone? What do you mean by optimization?
Sir, best output.
Best output. So, optimization is nothing but improving the design compared to existing one. Okay. Suppose if you have a connecting rod, or if you have a automotive chassis, okay, suppose the existing chassis can't withstand the particular impact load. So what you can do, you can improve the design so that it can withstand more impact load. So that is the optimization. So that way you can optimize the design. So next you are going to evaluate the design, whether the design is correct or not. You need to evaluate. Evaluate is nothing but you need to validate the design. Okay. Suppose if you have done CAE, that is analysis, you need to validate it with other methods. We have different methods. So next I will explain what are the different methods. Okay. We have experimental method. We have analytical method. We need to evaluate this. Okay. So once we evaluate, we need to go for process planning. That is how to manufacture, how to maintain the quality, how to get that product into the market. Everything we need to plan the process. Once we do the process planning, we need to go for production. Then we need to go for quality check or quality control. Next we'll go for packaging. Next it will go for customer. It will go to the customer. So once they get the review from the customer, again they will, if they want to change any changes in the design, again they can do the same cycle. They can use the same cycle to improve the design of the product. Okay, so all of you got it. So up to say from design to design optimization we'll do in the internship program. Okay, fine. So next, so here we have we can solve any engineering problem in mechanical. We have three methods. Okay, so one is analytical method, another is numerical method, and another is experimental method. See, analytical method, here we are going to solve the problems by using equations. And one more disadvantage of this analytical method is it is very difficult to find out the complex geometry. Okay, suppose this is a cantilever beam, right? We can easily solve by applying a load by considering the perpendicular distance by using these equations. Suppose if you want to find out the stresses for piston, for connecting rod, for bearings, okay, like chassis, it is very difficult to find out by using analytical method. If you try to do solving by using analytical method, it will be time consuming. Okay, so that's why engineers has developed the numerical method to overcome the problems in the analytical method. So numerical method, see here we are going to use numerical values. Okay, so the algorithm that has been developed in the software, so directly we need to apply the load. So which to the complex geometry or any kind of geometry, and so that we can solve and we can find out the stresses, deformations, strains, total strength of the component, everything we can evaluate, and we can find out the exact location of the stress. But in analytical method, it is very difficult to find out the exact location of the stress. Okay, so next we have experimental method. Okay, see, numerical method is nothing but finite element method. So in analytical method, what we are going to do, we are going to consider the load and distance and total area of the component, so we will get one maximum stress. But when it comes to numerical method, see why we the numerical method is the best method to solve any kind of engineering problem is, so in excess, suppose if you are finding out the stresses of a cantilever beam by using experimental method, so it is very difficult to find out exact location of the stress, right? All of you are getting?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So why? See, because it is tell me. Yeah. In a single component, so in any material, there is an infinite number of atoms, right? So there are infinite number of atoms. So for to the infinite number of atoms, we need to find out infinite number of stresses. Okay, to infinite number of stresses, it is very difficult to find out the stresses. So that's why we are going to convert this infinite number of atoms in a material into finite number of elements. That is called numerical method. Okay, that is finite element method, converting the infinite number of atoms into a finite number of elements. Okay, that is called finite element method. Okay, fine. So which is best compared to all these three? So engineers are preferring only the numerical method if they want to validate. If they want to see, validate is nothing but comparing the results with another method. Okay, so sometimes depending upon the problem, at last they will go for experimental method, okay, to validate the results with the numerical method. Sometimes depending upon the problem, they will go with this analytical method also. So all of you are getting?
Yes, sir.
So if you feel any doubts, you can ask.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so next we have types of analysis. So we have several types of analysis apart from this what I have quoted you. So these are the major types of analysis where the each and every mechanical component has to be performed. Okay, so one is linear static analysis, then modal analysis, fatigue analysis, thermal buckling and contact analysis. Okay, so next we'll see what is static structural analysis. Anyone? What is static structural analysis? What is static structural analysis? So static structural analysis is important because it can evaluate whether the specific structural design will be able to withstand the external loads and the internal stresses and forces expected for the design. So for each and every component, it is very important to find out the static structural analysis to evaluate whether the component can withstand the particular design load or not. Okay, so this is why we have to perform structural analysis. See, the primary reason the structural analysis is beneficial is to determine the cause of structural failure. Initially itself, we can evaluate the failure of the component once we perform structural analysis. Okay, so to perform this structural analysis, we have to find out the von Mises stress, that is called maximum stress, and another one is deformation, maximum deformation, then strain. Okay, fine. So this is the linear static structural analysis. So which is the graph? Which is this graph? This is
stress and strain graph.
Yeah. Okay. So here up to this limit, we have stress will be directly proportional to strain. That is elastic limit, right? Okay. Up to here, we will call it as a linear static analysis. After this, that is non-linear static analysis. Okay. There will not be any linearity between stress and strain. Okay. So next. So leave it. These are all the things I will explain you at the time of analysis. So why linear static analysis? 90% of the time, the primary product structural behavior can be understood using linear static analysis. See, so suppose if you are finding out any strength of if you are finding out the strength of any component. So once you perform static structural analysis, you can study the behavior of the component to the particular load. That is why we have to perform static structural analysis. So next, a linear static analysis is an analysis where a linear relation holds between applied force and the displacement. What I have explained to you, the linear relation between stress strain. So in practice, this is applicable to structural problems, whereas stress remains in the linear elastic range of the used material. So to find out this, the material should be isotropic material. If the material is isotropic material, so what is isotropic material? What is isotropic material?
Homogeneous material?
No, I am asking you isotropic material. Can you please switch on your videos? Yes, tell me now. Shivraj, Abhay, Abhilash. What is isotropic material? ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ವಾ?
ಗೊತ್ತು ಸರ್, ಬಟ್ ಹೇಳಕ್ ಬರ್ತಿಲ್ಲ.
ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳಿಸುತ್ತಂಗ ಹೇಳು
ಸರ್. ನೀವ್ ಹೇಳ್ಬಿಡಿ ಸರ್.
Abhay, simple material properties remains constant in all the direction. Okay, even though if you apply a load, simple alwa. Homogeneous, that is reverse. Okay. Fine. Okay. So let me continue. Fine. So in a linear static analysis, the model stiffness matrix is constant. So here we are going to consider the stiffness matrix as constant, and the solving process is relatively short compared to non-linear analysis. Suppose if you are finding out the linear static analysis for connecting rod, it will take lesser time compared to non-linear, because see, in non-linearity we are going to consider from non-linear properties. So rigidity modulus, bulk modulus, everything we are going to consider, so that it will take more time to solve nonlinear. And also we required and we require the non-linear material properties. Okay, to solve the problem. So next, therefore, for the first estimate, the linear static analysis often used to prepare to perform a full non-linear analysis. Before performing non-linear, so it is prepared to perform linear analysis also. Okay. So next, see, linear static is nothing but in a static condition, we are going to apply a load and we are going to find out the strength of the component. That's it. Okay. Fine. Next. What are all the results we can find out in linear static analysis? One, we can find out the static structural analysis. Okay. So, sorry, one, total and directional displacement, one Mohser stress, different type of stresses like normal, shear, bending, and principal stress. Okay. And then you can evaluate different strains, factor of safety, we can find out reaction forces, contact status. So everything we can find out once you perform static structural analysis. Okay, what do you mean by one Mohser stress?
Don't know.
See, one Mohser stress is nothing but is a type of failure. It is a failure criteria where we are going to find out the. See, one Mohser stress is nothing but a maximum stress. That's it, in a simple way. So why we are going to consider one Mohser stress? So every material is having its own ultimate stress, right? Yield stress. We can consider yield stress. Okay. So once the one Mohser stresses reaches or exceeds the yield stress, then the material may fail at any time. Okay. So if the one Mohser stress is lesser than the yield stress, then we can say that the material or design is safe. Okay. So in a simple way, you just remember. Fine. So this is about the static structural analysis. So this is one of the example to find out the static structural analysis. This is pneumatic cylinder cover. So here, say this is the pneumatic cylinder. Here the cover has been placed. The cover. So here there will be a high internal pressure will be applied inside the cylinder cover so that we can find out the strength of this component in a static condition. So one, see here we have a material properties like Young's modulus, Poisson's ratio, and internal pressure. Okay, so these are the material properties we have to consider to find out the static structural analysis. What are the outcome we have to get? So maximum deformation, maximum stress, that is one Mohser stress, radial stress, axial stress, circumferential stress, and directional stress. Okay, these are all the stresses we have to find out. Okay, so this is how. So here the pressure has been applied. So everything we'll learn in ANSYS workbench. So I'll explain you how to perform this. Next we have model analysis. What do you mean by model analysis? See, model analysis is nothing but frequency analysis. So why we have to perform model analysis? To find out the natural frequency of a component. See, model analysis is performed to find out the fundamental frequencies. Fundamental frequencies are nothing but a natural frequency. Okay. And their associated behavior, that is mode shape. Okay. So to perform this fundamental analysis, so we need to perform static analysis also to understand the behavior of the component. Okay. So what is resonance? What do I mean by resonance? See, model analysis is nothing but vibration analysis or frequency analysis. So it can be done to find out the vibrational behavior of a component. Okay, the resonance is nothing but vibration. Okay, so why we need to perform, why we have to find out the natural frequency in model analysis? So every system or every structure or every component is having its own operating frequency. Suppose consider this structure. Okay, here we are going to find out the natural frequency of this motor. See, we are going to find out the natural frequency of this motor. So if the operating frequency of this entire system is 60 hertz, that is, if the motor rotates at 3600 rpm, what will be the frequency? That is, that we have to divide it by 60. Here we will get 60 hertz. So this is the operating frequency. So when the vibration occurs, when the operating frequency coincides with the natural frequency, then resonance occurs, then vibration occurs. All of you are getting? So it is very important to find out the modal analysis to find out the natural frequency. Once you get the natural frequencies, you need to check whether it is coinciding with this operating frequency or not. Okay. See, the structure would vibrate with high amplitude and would eventually fail once it matches with the operating frequency. Suppose if your operating frequency is 60 hertz, if you are getting natural frequency is around 60, that is 58, 59 or 61, 62 like that, then we can say that structure may vibrate with high amplitude and it may fail. Okay. So it is very important to find out the natural frequency, and those natural frequencies should be beyond this 60 hertz. Then only the material may not vibrate. Okay. So this is very important. You need to understand the concept. Next. So this is one of the best example of failure of a structure without performing proper performance of natural modal analysis. This is the Tacoma Narrow Bridge. So the failure has been occurred due to twisting mode. Okay. So here we are going to find out the modes. So I will explain it. So you will get clarity once I solve the problem in ANSYS. Okay. Don't worry. You will get it. So these are all the basics. I will share this presentation with you. You can refer. So these are all you have studied in your kinematics of machines. So next we have, so this is one of the example for modal analysis. So this is the aircraft wing. For the particular aircraft wing, we have found out. Okay. And one more thing you have to remember, to find out the natural frequency, we should not apply any loads. Without loads, we need to find out the natural frequency of a component. Only we need to constrain the component. So this is also one of the best example for modal analysis. This is Audi car bumper. So one project we have done in this. So what we have done? So one material is fiber material, that is carbon fiber composite material, and another support structure we have used structural steel, aluminium alloy, titanium alloy and magnesium alloy. So we have validated the, we have optimized the material so that it can withstand higher loads and it can it should not be vibrate for the particular speed. Okay. So this is not required, leave it. So this is the contact analysis. So this can be done while you are having assembly. So this is a bridge. So this is a Kelvis pin assembly. Here you just observe. So it has been used to connect with this structure and with this rope. Okay. So supporting structure, it has been connected with the pin. So here we are going to apply a load. So this is yoke. Okay. So once we apply a load, there is a contact between this pin, this pin and this yoke and this fork type structure is there, pin type. So there will be a contact. So once we apply a load, there will be a high contact between these components. So between contacts, we need to find out the contact stresses. What are the stresses are developing between these two? That is called contact analysis. So it has to be done in most probably in the bearings or in some assemblies like assembly of camshaft and the connecting rod, assembly of camshaft, valves and engine cylinder head. So there are several applications of this, so that we can find out the contact analysis. So next we have thermal analysis. So this thermal analysis I will explain you at the time of analysis part, otherwise you will forget this. So there are several concepts are there, so that you can easily explain while solving the problem. Okay, all of you got it?
Yes sir.
Any doubts?
No.
Okay, so next what I will do, wait, okay, so next I'm going to explain you one of the project, so that you can you will get an idea how to start the project and how to execute it. Okay, so I will show you one of the best example of previous report, that is design and analysis of crankshaft. Okay, let me share that. Share. So all of you are getting this?
Sir, yes, sir.
Okay. So initially, what you have to do is first. So here we have done this project on design and model analysis of automotive crankshaft for material optimization. We have tried to optimize the material. So suppose consider for the manufacturing of crankshaft, if currently they are using structural steel or aluminium alloy like that. So you can try to optimize. See, suppose consider structural steel is having more weight. Okay, or structural steel cannot withstand higher loads, or structural steel is getting more stresses, so that you can try the different materials, and choosing the material is very important. You can't choose materials blindly. That's why it is very important to study the entire introduction about the particular component. Okay, suppose, see here we have tried to optimize the material. So initially what you need to do is abstract part and all, you can do it later. So first thing you have to do with the introduction part. Okay, you need to do individually. I will assign you. Okay, so I will message you the project name, so that you can do it by yourself. All of you are getting?
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
Yeah. So once, suppose if I have given you connecting rod or piston or engine cylinder or cylinder head or cylinder valve or aircraft wing or fuselage structure or flywheel, like that, any component, first you have to do introduction part. Why the introduction part is important is you should know in and out of the component, what exactly the component is, what exactly the main function of the component, what are all the loads, what are all the boundary conditions, what are all the materials we can use to manufacture the particular component, what are the advantages, what are the disadvantages, what are the applications, entire thing you need to do in the introduction part. Okay, all of you are getting? So yeah, so this is the introduction part. So you need to explain each and everything. See here. So here crankshaft diagram they have mentioned. So at least 15 pages you have to do the introduction part. See the principle of crankshaft. So dig it, okay? Google it, dig it, and get the information. And you need to explain this. All of you are getting? See here nomenclature. So not same what I have, whatever I am showing you, not same thing you have to do. So depending upon the component you have to do. Okay, see here, design consideration, crankshaft design consideration. So once you do the introduction part, you should have a capable to explain in and out of the particular component. All of you are getting? So that is the main reason that you can do introduction part. See here, everything, the types of crankshaft we have mentioned, single cylinder, multi-cylinder crankshaft. See here. So what are the types of crankshaft? Forged crankshaft is there, machined crankshaft is there. See, machining process is there. That is machined crankshaft. See, there are several things are there you can put. Okay. So once you do introduction part, once you understand in detail about the component, next you need to do literature survey. Okay. So literature survey you have to do. So you have to download the papers. So how to download the papers, I will show you. So 1 minute. So you just open the Google. Suppose if I have given you the design and analysis of chassis or design analysis of flywheel. What you have to do is, all of you are getting the screen, Google.
Yes, sir.
Okay, what you need to do is just type analysis of automotive connecting rod journal PDF. Like this you need to type. Okay, so suppose if I have given you automotive connecting rod, you just type it, analysis of automotive connecting. Suppose if I have given you the flywheel, automotive flywheel, just type analysis of automotive flywheel journal PDF. Give enter. So once you give enter, you will get many papers. See, suppose if you want, you just click this research get paper. So once you click this, so you just click on this download. Minimum 15 papers you need to download. So once you click, you will get the paper here. So click it. So why you need to refer these papers means, see here. So here you will get many things. See here, design analysis of automotive, analysis of connecting rod. So these are the authors. Okay, they are the authors. Next, we have abstract. So abstract means it is a heart of the paper. So once you read abstract, you can able to understand what exactly he has done. So specifications you will get. You will get loads, boundary condition, what are the loads applied. You will get the model. So in literature survey, you have to find out what exactly the paper is. Okay, all of you are getting?
See, yeah, here, sir.
You need to write, yes, the sir. Review paper like this. Suppose, see, Ravi Kumar Goyal, Harshvardhan, see, they are the, so this is the proper format you have to maintain. So first paper, author name, made stress analysis and optimization of crankshaft using CAE. The fundamental objective of this paper is changed into suggest the choicest design parameters of the prevailing crankshaft by means of changing the design variables like journal diameter, cranking. See, several parameters are there. So you need to check what are the parameters they have considered to do particular analysis. Okay. So you just make a note some of the points so that you have to concentrate on these things while studying the literature papers. So first thing is the objective of the paper. Make a note down. First thing is objective of the paper. Consideration of design parameters. Consideration of design parameters. Next, loads and boundary conditions. Then optimization, what optimization he has done. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yes. If you get any doubts, you can message me, okay, while doing this. So first you do one thing. First download one or two papers. You just study. So first you finish it off introduction part. Then you come to literature part. You have to do it by yourself. At any instant, if you feel any doubts, you can message me. Okay. So next, once you do the literature survey, so next part is you need to define the objective of your project. Suppose in this project, the primary objective of the current work is to study the stress of crankshaft with the different materials like structural steel, chilled cast iron, titanium alloy, and aluminium alloy. So we have used four different materials to find out the stresses in the crankshaft so that we have finalized the design which are having lesser stresses. Okay, here in this project we have optimized the material. So methodology, what methods you are using? If you are using, see, CAD model of design will be created, FE model of the design will be created, analysis under static and model conditions will be done. Okay, so not all type of analysis should be done in all the components, depending upon the loads, depending upon the boundary conditions, depending upon the operating condition of the component, you need to decide which type of analysis you can perform. All of you are getting? So based on the results obtained in analysis, the design will be finalized in the different stages. So this is our methodology. So I will share with you. So results and discussions. So results and discussions is the major part. So first you need to add the what exactly the geometry you are using. So try to get the geometry in the literature paper itself. So we'll take the particular paper, we can optimize it. Okay, so next. So if you have any design calculation, you can add the calculations here. So next we have FEA results with the different materials. So next you need to add the different, see, this is the finite element model. So we have divided the infinite number of atoms into finite number of elements. These are all the elements. Okay. So next, so I will just share this with you. So here first we have found out the linear static analysis of single cylinder crankshaft with structural steel. This is the structural steel. These are the material properties. Material properties are important. See here, we have found out the one measure stresses. See, so this is the one measure stress. Yeah, for the particular load. So here we have applied a load. See, applying the loads are very important, loads and boundary conditions. Yeah. See, during expansion of piston, there is a, here it has been connected to connecting rod. So this is connected to bearing. So once the expansion occurs, what happens? There will be a load. There will be a pressure on this surface. And here it is a fixed. For this particular loading condition, what will be the one measure stress? We have to check. See here. We are getting around 17.84. Okay, that is maximum stress. Where exactly we are getting? Here. So in this location. Okay. So you have to do the same format. So this is the deformation. Maximum deformation we are getting around 0.0019 mm. So what you need to do? You need to perform for all the materials. See here, this is the modal analysis. So we have used 10 natural frequencies. See here we have the 10 natural frequencies. These are all the natural frequencies we have got. See here, 10 natural frequencies. Operating frequency is 60 hertz. We are getting 5000 above. So that's why. So no one natural frequency is coinciding with the operating frequency, hence no resonance occurs. Okay, summary. The above table shows that the natural frequency generated, the maximum natural frequency in the crankshaft with chilled cast iron is 10,885. So here individually we have done. At last, if you go to last, yeah. So this is how you have to compare the results. See here, results of linear static analysis for different material. Structural steel, we are getting shear stress, one mass stress like this. So once we compare with all, we are getting lesser stresses in titanium alloy, okay, and lesser deformation also. So these, all the deformations are negligible, and the minimum frequency and maximum frequency here we are getting this. So once we compare with all, so no one material natural frequency is coinciding with the operating frequency that we can justify it. So next, here we can write the conclusion. So you need to write the conclusion like this. So linear static analysis and model analysis has been performed by using finite element method for different materials of crankshaft. From the above FE analysis of crankshaft, the following conclusions are made. One mass stress and maximum deformation has been plotted for different performance of crankshaft. We have plotted one mass and maximum deformations. Next, from the above analysis, it can be observed that one mass stresses in the crankshaft with structural steel and chilled cast iron are more. We are getting more stresses compared to titanium and aluminium alloy. Okay, so maximum deformation is negligible, so that's why we can neglect it. So next, we have maximum shear stress is in titanium alloy and aluminium alloy is lesser compared to structural steel. But one thing you need to focus on, the cost also while you are optimizing the material. See, from the model analysis, it can be observed that none of the natural frequencies are coincides with the operating frequency, hence no resonance occur. So finally, this is the conclusion. Finally, it can be concluded that from the above results, the titanium alloy and aluminium alloy are suitable for manufacturing of crankshaft due to lesser stresses. We are getting lesser stresses, that's why we can use these two. But since aluminium alloy is cost effective and lighter weight, hence in the point of cost optimization, crankshaft with aluminium alloy is suitable and sustainable. This is how you can write the conclusion of your project. All of you are getting? So initially you feel difficulty. Once you start doing it, yes, you sir. Get an idea. Okay, I will share this report. You just refer this. So next, if you have any scope for future work, you can write. So we can do fatigue analysis. We can do static analysis for different loading conditions. Okay. So next we need to
minimum
write
how many?
Yes, tell me.
Sir.
Yes,
sir.
Yes,
minimum how many literature paper we should write, sir?
15. 10 to 15.
15.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
First you do one or two paper and send it to me. I will check it and I will tell you what are all the corrections you need to do. Okay. So these are all the basics of finite element analysis and about the project. So in the next session, I am going to show how to perform the analysis using ANSYS workbench. Okay. Any doubts?
Yes, sir. No,
sir. So if you have any doubts, you can message me. Okay. So shall I wind up the session?
Yes, sir.
So tomorrow morning, actually, I am planning to visit your college because your HOD has been called me. See, we are making an MOU with your college for training and placement.
Then evening at what time you will be, sir?
If possible, I will take in the morning. Okay, from 8 to 9. Okay, or else I will take day after tomorrow. So meanwhile, you start doing introduction. Mm-hmm. After completion of introduction part, you start literature survey. Okay. This is the assignment.
So part first, you should give like what's the project, sir.
I will assign you.
Then we can able to write the introduction also.
Yes. I will message you by the night itself. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Shall I end the session? Yes. Tell me.
Sir, can you just tell me about AI, about artificial intelligence, whether it's required for mechanical to?
Yes, it is required, man.
So you should learn about data science, about like Python. To learn about artificial intelligence.
See,
some of the companies are equipped like artificial intelligence over the basic knowledge.
Yes, for robotics and automation, it is mandatory to know artificial intelligence and machine learning. Okay, so machine learning is very important. So before that, you need to learn the Python. See, because machine learning, we can do it by using Python. Machine learning, we can do it by using MATLAB. You know MATLAB?
No, sir. MATLAB, I heard somewhere, but not sure.
Okay, so you can do it. So it is having more demand. So you can do, depend upon your interest.
Yeah, I'm doing Python because some of the, I attended today webinar on like IIT Mumbai.
Yes.
Yeah, they are told about artificial intelligence. Yes, how they are going to recruitment.
See, many of the universities has introduced BTech in artificial intelligence and machine learning.
Okay.
So you have more scope in that. Especially, see, one thing I will tell you. So mechanical engineers can enter in any field. So being a mechanical engineer, you have greater scope in this also. In artificial intelligence, machine learning. So why I will tell you, IT people will do only software part. They can develop. But a mechanical engineer, they can develop the software part as well as they can develop the hardware part also. So that you will get an entire idea how we can import that software part into hardware part. And we can learn both the things. We can learn both the hardware part as well as this software part. So that is why for mechanical engineers, it is having more demand in this field, robotics and automation. So there we are using this artificial intelligence and machine learning. Because if you go to Toyota assembly line, entire thing is machine learning. Assembly line in Toyota. So you have greater scope. If you have interest, you can learn it. Are you learning or yet to learn?
I am learning Python, sir, present. But okay. I don't have any idea of artificial intelligence because whether we can learn or not.
Initially you go with machine learning. So by using Python, by using Python only, you can do artificial intelligence and machine learning.
Yeah, that's why I'm learning.
You can go ahead with that. And
that's why it's fine.
Yeah. Simultaneously, you just start learning this CAD software also. Why I'm telling you? So both the part you can handle. So to development of the product with the implementation of software. Suppose if you have 1 minute. Yes. Suppose if you are a mechanical engineer, you can develop the product, you can implement those applications into that product. So I will always prefer this machine learning for mechanical engineers. Because we have developed some of the projects for BE mechanical. So we do handle the academic projects. So we have provided the projects on machine learning also. For mechanical engineering students.
Okay.
To for your seniors, we have given some of the projects on machine learning, like some of the basic softwares are there, basic projects are there. See, plant disease detection, but plant disease detection we have done, and one more thing is there. I forgot those projects title. I can't remember. So recently, for your seniors, we have given some of the purely mechanical based project. One is the Skysaver, and another one is chairless chair.
Okay, sir.
So if you are if you have keen interest in machine learning, you do one thing, start learning all the things, you can implement those things in your academic projects also. That would be better, so that you will get an idea how to implement those machine learning into your mechanical components. Okay.
Okay,
okay, fine. So any doubts? Okay, yes, tell me, Abhay.
Yeah, nothing, sir. Thank you.
Okay, shall I wind up the session?
Yeah, sure, sir.
Okay, fine. Thank you.